In this video, I'm gonna show you how to set up and play inFamous 1 and 2 on PC. Both games are playable on the PS3 emulator RPCS3, and they require specific settings to increase performance, including the debug menu, which I'll show you on this video how to configure everything properly from the beginning, even if you have never used this emulator before. Let's get started. We'll begin by downloading RPCS3, the PS3 emulator. I'll put the link down below, and here on the main page, you just have to click here on the download button, and then you download the emulator for the operational system you're using. In my case, I'm using Windows, so I'm gonna click on this one, and then place it on the folder of your preference on your PC. It will come as a zipped file, so you have to extract it with either WinRAR or 7-zip. In my case, I'm using 7-zip, so I'm just gonna extract the file here. And you can go ahead and delete the original one. We're not gonna need that anymore. And to begin, you just have to double click here on rpcs3.ex to start the installation. And here there's a few options if you want to create a desktop shortcut and stuff. I would not recommend using the dark theme yet, so I'm gonna turn this off. And then just click here on do not show again, and I have read the quick start guide, and then just select here on continue. And there you go, we have RPCS3 on our computer. First, we have to install the PS3 firmware on the emulator, and we can get that on the official Sony website. This is the place right here, the link will be down below, and on this page, you want to scroll down here to the bottom a little bit, and where it says how to update PS3 system software, you want to click here on update using a computer. And then you just click on download PS3 update and place the file on the same emulator folder. If for some reason the download doesn't start when you click on it, then you have to click on it with the right button on your mouse and then select copy link address and then paste the link on your browser and press enter. Then the download will start. Now back on the emulator folder, I already downloaded my firmware here. It is this file, the PS3 update. Now you wanna go to the emulator and right here, click on file and click on install firmware. It should open the emulator folder by default. So now you just have to double click here on the PS3 update and it will install the firmware on RPCS3. Click here and do not show again and then click OK. And now it will install these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long. And while you wait for it to finish, this will be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. I would really appreciate it. Now with the emulator up, it's time to install the games, and you're gonna go back to the emulator folder, and inside you're gonna notice that there's this folder called games that was already created when we installed the emulator. So double click on it, and this is where we're gonna be placing the game files. And I can't show you here on the video where to go to get the games, so you're gonna have to either dump your copies into your PC or find them online. But this is against YouTube's policy, so I can't show that on the video. And regardless of how you got the games, the best playable format for them is on a folder like this one, and inside you're gonna have files similar to this one. And if you have them as a ISO, you're gonna have to extract them from the ISO with either WinRAR or 7-zip, that's up to you. But this format is good for RPCS3. So now you're gonna go back to the emulator and you're gonna click here on file and then you're gonna select add games. On the emulator root folder, you're gonna select the games folder and click on select folder. And just like that, the games will appear here. Or you can restart the emulator. This works as well. The game should appear here. Before you play these games, we have to configure them for the best settings, so we're not ready yet. And there are no patches for the first game, but there is one for Infamous 2. And there's an easy way to update your games on RPCS3. Using this tool right here, Rusty PSN, the link will be down below as well. So here on this page, you just want to click here on the latest release available, and then just scroll down here to the bottom, and you have to download this file right here, the Rusty PSN EGI Windows.zip. Download this file if you are using Windows like I am. You can place it on the same emulator folder. Now back on the RPCS3 folder, the file is right here, the Rusty PSN that is, so you just have to extract the single .ex file that is inside of it with either WinRAR or 7-zip here. And then now you just have to double click here on the Rusty PSN.ex and the tool will open. Before you start downloading the patches, I want you to click here on this little gear so you can change the download location for the patches. In my case, I like to create a new folder on the emulator folder here called updates, just so that I can keep things organized, you know? And now go back to Rusty PSN and then select pick folder and then select that one updates folder that we just created. Remember, this is optional. This is up to you how you want to download this, but I like doing it like this. So now click here on save settings. Now to update the game, we're gonna need its serial code and we can get that on the emulator. So go back to RPCS3 and on Infamous 2, you're gonna click on it with the right button and then select the option from the bottom, copy info, and then you're gonna click on copy serial. Now go back to Rusty PSN and you're gonna paste the code right here like this and click on search for updates. And it's going to list all the updates available for the game. There's 4 for Infamous 2. So you can go ahead and select here on download all. We're gonna need all of these patches here to get not only the best performance, but to also get rid of bugs as well. The download is complete. Now let's go back to RPCS3 and you're gonna click on file and then click on install packages. On the RPCS3 folder, you're gonna double click on that updates folder that we created. And then there's going to be a folder with the serial code of the game, double click on that, and inside all the 4 patches for Infamous 2. So you're gonna go ahead and select everything with your mouse, just click and hold the left button, highlight everything, and then click on open. And inside RPCS3, it's going to list all the updates. Make sure that they are in order, by the way. If you try to install them in the incorrect order, you're gonna have problems later. So make sure there's 1.01, 02, 03, and 04, exactly like this. Now go ahead and click on install. This should only take a little while to finish. And there you go, the updates are installed. And now the game is fully updated. Now let's configure both games for the best settings. And this is the most important part of this video. I'm gonna start with Infamous 1 and then move on to the second game. Before anything else, I want you to click here on config just once, let this window open, and then you're gonna close it down. This is so that we can tweak some of the settings so that we can enable the debug menu. You're gonna go back to the emulator folder right here, and there's going to be this folder here called gconfigs already created. So you're gonna double click on it, and inside there's going to be this file here called current settings. And I'm gonna need you to open this one with the notepad from Windows or your favorite notepad software. As long as you can open this one and edit it, it works as fine. So on currentsettings.ini, if you just double click it, it should open right away. But if that doesn't work for you, you're gonna click on it with the right button and then you're gonna select here open with, and then you're gonna select the notepad. But if that doesn't show up, you're gonna click here on choose another app. And from this drop-down menu, you're gonna select a notepad. It should be here somewhere. And then just select it and click on OK, like this. Now, on this file, the option that we're gonna need is right here on the top under the meta section here. It's this one, show debug tab equals false. So right here, you're simply going to delete the false and you're gonna write true. Exactly like this, simple enough, right? And with that done, don't forget to save this, by the way. Click on file and then click on save, or you can press Ctrl S on your keyboard and we're now ready. And now, if you had the emulator open while doing all of this like I was, go ahead and close this down and then just reopen the emulator once again. Now the debug tab will show up. So let's start with Infamous 1, of course. Click on it with the right button and then select create custom configuration. This window will show up, and right here on the CPU tab, the only option that we have to change is under SPUX float accuracy, change it from approximate to accurate. Now let's go to the GPU tab right here, and on render, make sure that you have Vulkan selected here. This is the best video renderer for this emulator, but if your GPU is outdated, you're only gonna have OpenGL in which you can play the game, but the performance won't be very good. So make sure that Vulkan is selected here And on an isotropic filter, you can change this one to 16x. This will make the game look much better, and it has minimal impact on performance. And on Z-Code accuracy, change it from precise to relaxed. If you want to increase the game's resolution, you're gonna leave the default resolution at the recommended 720p here, and you're gonna use the resolution scale. This is gonna require more of your CPU, of course, but it will not introduce any bugs or anything like that on this game. But I would recommend just playing this on the default resolution just to keep it safe. On the resolution scale threshold, change this one to 256 by 256. You can use the keys on your keyboard to be more precise, but this is the value that you need here. And finally, on additional settings, you're gonna enable multi-thread RSX and texture streaming. Now let's go to the advanced tab, and right here on sleep timer's accuracy, you're gonna change it from use sleep only to as host. And on RSX FIFO accuracy, change it from fast to atomic. And for the final setting, you're gonna head over to the debug tab that we enabled here, and you're gonna click on disable Z-Code occlusion queries. Now we are finished here, so click on apply and then save custom configuration. And now we're gonna do the settings for inFamous 2. So once again, click on the game with the right button and then click again on create custom configuration. The settings are pretty much the same as the first game, so if you didn't saw that, I'm gonna repeat it here. With the exception of CPU, we don't have to change anything here. So move over to GPU here and make sure that the render is set to Vulkan. But if your GPU is outdated, you're only gonna have OpenGL, in which you can play the game, but the performance won't be very good. But if you have it, definitely go ahead and select Vulkan here. Change the anisotropic filter from auto to 16x. This will make the game look much better, and it has minimal impact on performance. And on Z-Code accuracy, change this one to relaxed. And if you want to increase the game's resolution, keep the default resolution at the recommended 720p here and increase the resolution scale. But this can introduce some bugs, like the character faces missing and also their models as well. So just to be safe, I would recommend playing this at 100%. On additional settings, click on right color buffers and texture streaming. Now let's go to the advanced tab right here, and on sleep timer's accuracy, change this one to as host. And on RSX FIFO accuracy, change this one to atomic. Now on the debug menu that we enable here, you're gonna click on disable Z-Code occlusion queries. And we are done here, so click on apply and then save custom configuration. Lastly, we have to configure the controller. So you're gonna click here on pads and this window will show up, and this emulator has an automatic mapping function. So if you don't have your controller plugged in, go ahead and do that right now. And when you do, if you click here on handlers where it says keyboard, it's going to list all the devices available for RPCS3. So you're just gonna click on the controller you're using and the emulator will do the rest for you. In my case, I have an Xbox controller, so I'm gonna click here on X input, and just like that, the configuration is ready. Now, when you're done, go ahead and click here on save, and we're ready to start the game. So you just gotta double click on the game you wanna play. It's going to ask if you want to install the digital manual of the game. That's up to you if you wanna read that later. And when you start the game for the first time, it's going to compile these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long. It's going to depend on how strong your CPU is. And with that, both games are good to go and you can start playing them. I have many tutorial videos like this on the channel, so if you like what you saw, don't forget to check out my other stuff, and also subscribe to the channel and leave a like on this video. I would really appreciate it. Thank you for watching, have fun, and as always, I'll see you soon.